The performance of the transmission line depends on the parameters of the line. The term performance includes efficiency and voltage regulation of the line. Therefore, a sound concept of these parameters is necessary to make the electrical design of transmission lines a technical success. In today's video, I'm going to talk about these parameters, or in other words, the constants of the transmission line. Hi, I'm Benila and you're watching The Learning Curve. The four parameters that affects the performance of the transmission line as an element of power system are resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance. These are also called the constants of the transmission line. These parameters are uniformly distributed along the whole length of the line. Resistance is the opposition of line conductors to current flow. The power loss in the transmission line depends mainly on this resistance. The resistance of the line is given by R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the conductor, and A is the area of cross-section of the conductor. Now, I'm going to explain three facts about this resistance. The resistivity is the material property of the conductor. It does not depend on size or shape of the conductor, but it varies with temperature. This means the resistance also varies with temperature. Instead of a single solid conductor, we use a stranded conductors in transmission lines. For stranded conductors, alternate layers of strands spiral in opposite directions. Spiraling makes the strands 1 or 2% longer than the actual conductor length. Therefore, the resistance of the stranded conductor is slightly more than the solid conductor of an equivalent cross-sectional area. When a conductor is carrying alternating current or AC, this current is not uniformly distributed over the whole cross-section of the conductor. The current tends to concentrate only near the surface of the conductor. This is called the skin effect. In DC, there is no skin effect. There, the current is uniformly distributed over the whole cross-section of the conductor. The useful cross-sectional area or effective cross-sectional area of the conductor will be more when a DC current flows through it and less when an AC current flows through it. Since the resistance is inversely proportional to area, the conductor resistance is more for AC than for DC. Now, let's move on to inductance. When a current flows through a conductor, a magnetic field is created. The magnetic field generated follows any changes in the current. From Faraday's law of induction, any change in magnetic field through a circuit induces an electromotive force or voltage in the conductors. This induced voltage has the effect of opposing the change in current. This tendency of an electrical conductor to oppose a change in electric current flowing through it is called inductance. The interesting fact here is the current flowing in one conductor can induce a voltage in the neighboring conductor. Therefore, while designing the spacing between the conductors, it is very important to consider the inductance. The next parameter is the capacitance. A capacitor is a device consisting of two electrical conductors that are separated by a non-conducting substance. The non-conducting substance can be any insulator or even air. Coming back to our transmission lines, we have conductors separated by air. This means they act as capacitors. The effect of a capacitor is known as capacitance. From this, we can conclude that the capacitance is also the function of the conductor's arrangement. The conductance is normally due to leakage over the line insulator. Now, let's see the electrical representation of the transmission line. Resistance and inductance are elements in series with the line because they are the properties of the conductor. capacitance and conductance are shunt elements because they are the properties of dielectric material or insulators between the conductors. These parameters are uniformly distributed along the whole length of the line. The shunt conductance is almost always eliminated in overhead transmission lines. The performance of the transmission line can be analyzed conveniently if distributed parameters are considered lumped. If you go through the textbooks that explains the parameters of the transmission line, you will realize that resistance is explained just in one paragraph, while the author took pages to explain the inductance and capacitance. It feels like resistance is not given enough importance. Actually, resistance is of equal importance, but it requires less explanation since it's not a function of conductor arrangements. So, while designing the transmission line arrangements, inductance and capacitance are given more importance than the resistance. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.